serving, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. I was your foe, still your love for me. You have been so, so good to me. When I found no worth, you paid it all for me. And you have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, but still I found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down. You won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, but still I'm found, leaves the deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
Out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, the ocean's deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. grace abounds and deepest wanted. The sovereign hand will be mine. Grace abounds in deepest mountains, the sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feeling peace abounds me, never failed and it won't stop now. I will call upon your name. So we rest in your embrace when I am yours and you are mine. Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call.
Thank you. I Almighty God and Father, it is a certain faith and your Son who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, that through fruit of all who fall asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Margarita, who has gone to the grace of Christ, may share it in joy of his resurrection. We ask it through our Lord Jesus, like your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Lamentations. My soul is deprived of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell myself my future is lost, all that I hope for from the Lord. The thought of my homeless poverty is warm with anger. Remembering it over and over leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as a reason to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They are renewed each morning, so great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
hear my prayer. O Lord, hear my prayer. Hearken to my pleading in your faithfulness. In your justice, answer me. And enter not into judgment with your servant, for before you, no living man is just. I remember the days of old. I meditate on all your doings. The works of your hands I ponder. I stretch out my hands to you. My soul thirsts for you like parched land. Hasten to answer me, O Lord, for my spirit fails me. At dawn, let me hear of your kindness, for in you I trust. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit guide me on level ground.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you not aware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were baptism into his death. We were buried with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. If we have been united with him through likeness to his death, so shall we through a life resurrection. This we know. Our old self was crucified with him, so that the sinful body might be destroyed, and we might be slaves to sin no longer. A man who is dead has been freed from sin. If we have died with Christ, we believe we'll hear also together. We know that Christ once raised from the dead will never die again. Death has no more power over him. This is the word of the Lord.
Glory to you, O Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory to you, O Word of God, Lord Jesus Christ. I am the life of the world, says the Lord.
Where you've been in that tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near the Therefore, we celebrate the memory of his death, resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give it peace and give it this working with your presence and minister to you. Have we pray that we take the body of the Christ, we may be guided to our Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread the rule of the world, and repeat the fullness of charity to other Francis, our Pope, Sir, our Bishop, and other clergy. Remember your servant, Margarita, whom you have called today from this world to yourself, when that she was united with your Son, and that like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters upon us living in hope of resurrection, and honor with that your mercy, welcome them into the life of faith. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, the best apostles, and all the saints, who are present to you through the happy ages, could be very difficult ever to turn a life with grace and glory fire to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory of Christ is forever and ever. For my divine teacher, be there to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And it is not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant this nowadays, after the heavens of mercy, we may be always repentant sin and save all distress as we await for this hope and the coming of Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, as you said, the apostle of peace, we may give you through recognizing the faith of your church and graciously grant her peace and unity in the course of your who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Because Jesus takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be with you. Thanks for your mercy. Equal the body of Christ. Thank you.
What will it be like when my pain is gone and all the worries of this world just fade away? What will it be like when you call my name and at that moment when I see you face to face? Waiting my whole life to hear you say, well done, well done, my good and faithful one. Welcome to the place where you belong. Well done, well done, my beloved child. You have run the race and now you're when tears are washed away and every broken thing will finally be made whole. What will it be like when I come into your glory, standing in the presence of a love so beautiful? Waiting my whole life for this day, and I have lived my life to hear you say, well done, well done, my good and faithful one. Welcome to the place where you belong. Well done, well done, my beloved child. You have run the race and now you're home. Welcome to the place where you belong. What will it be like when I hear that sound of all of heaven's angels crying out, singing holy, holy, holy are you, Lord? Singing holy, holy, holy. I have lived my life to hear you say, well done, well done, my good and faithful one. Welcome to the place where you belong. Well done, well done, my beloved child. You have run the race and now you're home. Welcome to the place where
let's pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us a strength by our sister Margarita may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Good morning. Good morning. sign. Can you hear me?
This is my son, Justin. He's my backup. Not sure if I can pull this off under the contest. So anyways, so there is a little verse, don't grieve. Today I let my loved ones, and as I go, I pray, Lord, don't let them grieve too much. Because I died today. Let there be no wailing yet in the house, the same home that has laughter and answers to my calls. I pray they will take comfort, accept in the true way, and listen as I tell them things today. Love will be forever, I promise, and it will last. So love me more than you ever have with the ones that have passed. At last I remember the growing love to be when our eyes meet once again for all eternity. So Margarita, Bertha, for Osborne, Los Angeles, March 10, 1928. She passed away February 11, 2022 in Ojai, California, graduated from Roosevelt High School in Boyle Heights in 1947, married our father, who seen on God in November 48. Loving mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, and friends of so many in her lifetime. We're gathered to celebrate the beautiful memory of our mother who has spent, who has been sent to heaven as an angel and become our, who was sent from the angel to become our mother. Mom has now completed her obligation to all of us and is finally called home. Be with the Lord, our sister Roseanne, many family members, friends, and the angels in heaven. Although we will truly miss her, we must accept the fact that she's now in peace and surrounded by those who have loved her. I can only imagine the celebration the way that it has been. Mothers bring us into this world, and it's hard to imagine life without them. They are. Mothers bring us into this world, and it's hard to imagine life without them. They are with us when we take our first breath, and often with them when they take their last breath. Unfortunately, you were not able to be by her side due to the COVID restrictions. Saying goodbye to our mother is heartbreaking. The feeling of being alone and at times lost our grief. The realization of now having to navigate life without her physical presence is mind-boggling and difficult to fix. Mom assisted her children in navigating our lives and comforting us when needed. She was always there, exemplifying the good in people and in life, especially when we were feeling down. Mom taught us to accept, love, and appreciate others without being judgmental. I personally have mastered most of those teachings, but not all. A mother of six children, 15 grandchildren, and 7 great-grandchildren, who she adored equally. Mom always prioritized her children throughout her lifetime, as well as her grandchildren and great-grandchildren in the later years. She always created quality time to spend with us, playing games, creating crafts, or just watching Friday night movies while enjoying her absolutely welcome toasted ham sandwiches. During school breaks, she also made time to include the neighboring children to join in game, playing, or creating crafts. Mom always seemed to do a lot with little or nothing. She was so creative with all the children. Growing up was not an easy task in our household. Financial stability was a big obstacle in our early days. But Mom always seemed to keep a smile and make the best of our bad situations. She made sure we were always cared for to the best of her ability. Personal hygiene, clean clothes, and being fed were always the number one priority. I personally remember a time in grammar school when the soles of my shoes were worn and in need of replacement. Funds were tight, so there was no visit to the shoe shop repairman. Of course, Mom had an alternative remedy by simply inserting cardboard as a secondary sole to keep my feet dry, and it worked. Mom made absolutely sure that my shoes were shined to perfection.
The shoe issues were eventually resolved, and I obtained my first set of taps. Oh, that was cool. Soon after, my sisters also acquired taps to be cool as well. Good things come to those who wait, she told me. I was 8 or 9 years old when Mom had me join the Cub Scouts, where I learned many valuable talents. This is where I mastered my craft of making helmets. Mother's Day was approaching, so it was time to produce some masterpieces for Mom's special day, and so I did. I made Mom a pair of the most hideous-looking earrings known to man. But at the time, I thought they were so very special and cool-looking. I knew Mom would have been proud of my masterpiece. Well, she was proud. Proud enough to wear them to Sunday church at least once. Mom and I laughed about that together years later. Fact is, she still had them somewhere within her personal belongings. Why she never threw them away beyond me. Another one of my special yet dumb memories where Mom saved our behind starts like this. At the age of 14 or 15, I discovered my passion for riding dirt bikes with my good buddy, Rick Chu, who lived on Paulus Avenue. We would ride the hills from morning to dark or until we ran out of gas. I also discovered how to drain gas out of Mom's gas tank to replenish my engine. I now wonder if she always knew and said nothing. It was summer break, and we were riding Elephant Hill, as it's now referred to, having a great time. Rick and I were riding double on Big Brother Ralph shoes, which was a big no-no. But we decided to go pop wheelies on Huntington Drive. Passing the Donut Depot, we encountered LA's finest, who soon gave us a chase. We headed up to Paulus Avenue at around 100 miles an hour, and we passed Pullman, where Mom will stop. She observed our predicament and returned home, opening the garage door, awaiting our arrival from the hills where we lost the thugs. We were scared and peeking out the window when the black and white appeared. They were about to leave Harriman when one of the kids mentioned a name, I shall not remain anonymous, that we were hiding in the garage. The officers asked Mom if they could have a look, and she said yes, but only if you have a report. The cops then departed our block. Mom came through for us yet again. She wasn't even mad. Her only words of encouragement were, keep it up, and you're going to eventually get caught. Mom loved the Seattle Seahawks football team and the Los Angeles Lakers basketball team. Mom went over to Amsterdam, Holland for Dana's transplant in the early part of 1990 and sat at her bedside for 3 months. That's the kind of mother she was. One night they told her Diana wouldn't make it until the morning. She suffered so much with Diana and Roseanne. She slept on the living room sofa at Roseanne's house for weeks. She never mentioned the sacrifices she made for us. She rarely discussed it afterwards and never sought praise for being such a dedicated mother to her children. She ingrained that dedication for us. Felicia and I, Peggy, took Mom to the casino a few years ago, and when we asked her if she had fun, she responded with yes. But it was not the same as in the days of the old times with her friends from Guadalupe Church. They all loved the buffet. Mom never enjoyed traveling much, but loved doing things with her children and grandchildren. She ingrained that dedication in us. What an awesome mother we had. She was a very beautiful person, internally and on the exterior as well. Memories are a funny thing. It's been over 1.5 months now, and I still look at my phone every morning, wondering when and if she left a new voicemail for me. I guess that's how strong a memory is. As those memories slowly fade, though, they'll never be completely gone. In my mind, it means our mother will never be completely gone. I don't know if this helps anyone else or not, but I find a lot of comfort and solace in that thought. In simply feeling like maybe her spirit is still with us, I also take comfort in knowing that she is in a better place. Mom is no longer sick anymore, and she can do all those things that she used to love to do. Sometimes death can be difficult. It's not always about the fact that the person died. However, death can also be a time for celebration. It can be a time to look back on that loved one's life and to realize all the great times that you had with them. Even though I'm sad, I'll always look back on those long conversations with my mom and smile. I'll look back on those birthday parties and remember how great they were with my siblings and all of our kids. They always had a great time with their grandma. So while I'm sad, I'll always try in my heart to celebrate the life that she did have. The following is a passage from her mother to her children. It reads as follows. To my children, please be kind to one another. Love each other as I have loved you. I will always be in your hearts. Know that I will be in peace with Roseanne and the rest of my family. God bless you all. Mom. While in the hospital with COVID last year, Mom left me a voice message all 29 days while I was in the ICU. I've never deleted any of them and continue to listen to them from time to time. They have become very special to me and I reflect on them often. I will now share one of them so that you can all hear her wonderful, caring voice one last time. Thank you all for joining us today to celebrate our mother's life.
How are you this morning? I hope you had a good night's sleep. I hope you have a good day today. And I hope the dinner yesterday was good. Yesterday was one of the happiest days of my life when I heard my son on the phone. I'm so glad you're doing better. And yes, soon you will be walking in the front door and giving me a big, big air hug. I love you, I pray for you, and I wish you only the best. May God bless you. Bye-bye.
Margarita de Garcia, and pray. Please stand. Before we go separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May all of our well express our affection for her, may it is our sadness and strength our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet him and greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquered all things, destroyed even death itself. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. We forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed be thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sins, now and at the hour of our death. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hand, Father of mercy, we commend our sister Margarita, and to serve certain hope that together we'll all be dying Christ, she will rise with him unto the last day. We give you thanks for the blessing which you bestow upon Margarita in this life. They are signed to us of the goodness in our fellowship with the same Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to confirm one another with a service of faith until we are made in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. So Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Rest in peace. Go in peace.